Let's go out to Teresa Marchetta, and I believe Teresa, you're with Debbie Wasserman Schultz.
I am, and actually, we just had Congresswoman Diana DeGette walk up, so we want to speak to her for a second. Thank you so much for coming by. First of all, talk to us about President Obama's performance tonight.
I thought President Obama did a great job of explaining how his policies have benefited the middle class and how they're going to benefit the middle class in the next 4 years as we move into a recovery. I thought that Governor Romney was really short on specifics, as he has been the whole election.
It seemed at points that the president was a little bit on the defensive, talking more about his record than being able to push forward with his plans in the next 4 years. Do you think there was enough of a balance there in his performance tonight?
I think in order to explain what the president's going to do, he has to talk about what the base that he started to build. And we can't forget the terrible economic downturn that we were in when he took office 4 years ago. So while we're not where we need to go, we certainly have come a long way. And the president explained that. And really, he talked about how his policies are going to help everybody, not just the top 1% in this country.
A lot of the early comments coming back, I think expectations a little lower for Governor Romney than for President Obama. And he's taken some criticism for being a little laid back, the president, tonight. Do you think he got, despite whatever the critics may say, do you think he got his point across to the American people as he set out to do?
I think the president looked really statesmanlike tonight. And from my perspective, I thought Governor Romney seemed a little over aggressive and didn't really say what his specific proposals were. It was like he was overcompensating for his lack of specific proposals tonight.
And how do you think Denver did, if you had to talk about putting on this debate?
Denver is really, really on a Rocky Mountain high. When I was in the convention in Charlotte last month, everybody said, well, this was a good convention, but not like Denver. And now here we are in the national spotlight again. Denver and Colorado and the university here did a wonderful job tonight. I'm really proud of our community and of our state.
Thank you so much for being with us, Diana DeGette. Thank you for stopping by.
Yes, absolutely.
We want to bring in the chair of the DNC now, Debbie Wasserman Schultz. Thank you so much for coming by, and it's an honor to have you here. Tell us about how you rated the president's performance tonight.
Well, I thought the president did a really good job. If you're listening at home, you had an opportunity to hear in real detail how President Obama has brought us from the worst economic crisis since the Great Depression to where we've made 30 straight months of progress in economic job growth and more jobs created in manufacturing than any time since the 1990s, 5 million jobs created in the private sector, and how he would move us forward over the next 4 years in job creation, 1 million manufacturing jobs created, and cutting oil imports in half and cutting tuition increases in half and passed his prologue. So looking at the president's record in bringing us forward, his plans will give us an opportunity to continue rebuild this economy from the middle class out.
Now, and the economy is a huge focus of the feedback we're trying to get tonight. Mm-hmm. Do you think the president gave enough specific examples of the things he will do going forward? We heard a lot about what he's accomplished up to this point, and he talked about his record quite a bit. Do you think he put out enough about his plans for the next 4 years tonight? And what do you think he focused on, I guess, the best tonight?
Well, I do think that was the clear contrast in this debate. I think President Obama was much more specific, gave real details about what his plans were to continue to move our economy forward by creating 1 million manufacturing jobs. We've already created more jobs in manufacturing than any time since the 1990s. President Obama wants us to make sure we can continue to do that by proposing to cut oil imports in half, stop relying on foreign oil, and continue the increase in domestic production that's occurred under President Obama's administration, and make sure that we can continue to invest in renewable energy so that we're not so reliant on fossil fuels that are finite. Make sure that we can cut tuition increases in half, ensure that more college students have an opportunity to get an education. And, you know, Mitt Romney, when pressed on details about how he would achieve his arguably laudable goals, got testy and defensive and really, you know, didn't want to get into any details on how he would do that.
Debbie Wasserman Schultz, chair of the DNC, thank you so much
thank
for stopping
you.
By.
Now
you have an
pleasure.
Early flight. We appreciate you staying up
welcome.
Late with us. Thanks
Absolutely.
So much.
No
so part of the feedback that we're hearing tonight, just reiterating the fact that President was composed, got his facts put across, and that's how the Democrats are playing it out on Spin Alley. Back to you guys.
All right, Teresa, thank you.